Hi, I'm Julie Faith Ann Balzer, your host for Make It Artsy. Fashion inspires art and vice versa. Today, Ray Missigman creates artistic jewelry that doubles as an art journal. Hi, Ray.
Hi, how are you?
So I'm super excited about these necklaces that you brought with you. They're cute, they're artful, and the best part, they repurpose art you've already made, right?
Right. Sometimes you want to show off your art or take it with you, but you don't have room for a journal or something. So this is a great way to have a little piece of it with you. So what we're going to do first is cut and perforate some strips.
But I want to talk about what we're cutting them out of, because this is actually artwork that you've made like in your journal or on paper or somewhere else separately.
And what you'll want to do is just scan it in at home. I just printed mine out on regular cardstock on an inkjet printer.
And I was going to say, this could be a giant painting. It could be something little big. It doesn't matter. You are now in control of it, and you get to reuse it.
And if you have something large, you can take a photo of it and scan it in, and you can shrink it down that way too. So you have a way to get it on a
which is super
piece.
Cool. And I have a piece here that's done in the electronic cutter. And now we have created a file for the book, which is essentially a series of rectangles, right?
Yes.
With perforations for the folds of the pages. And you can see it here on the screen. And I've even scanned in, you can see that image right in the back there, the actual, what we have right here. And if I want to make that scan a little bit lighter so that we can see things more clearly, there you go. So now what I can do is I can actually fussy cut. And of course, if you didn't have an electronic cutter, you can absolutely use scissors or a paper trimmer. And if you didn't have, if you didn't want to do perforation lines, you could of course do just like a bone folder or something to get those folds.
Right, a score tool, that
exactly.
type of thing.
Exactly. And if you had something like this Thrive here that you definitely wanted to go ahead and be in your book, you'd absolutely be able to see that, fussy cut it, captured onto a page. Right. Or let's say you wanted to obscure that, you could do that as well. And now the machine is just going to go ahead and cut these out for us. It's going to take about 2 minutes for us to do it, but now we have creative time to do whatever else we'd like. Right. So now that it's done, I'm gonna go ahead and pull it out, and we're just gonna wiggle the pieces on out that we want, tear away the excess here. Oh my gosh.
Awesome.
It's amazing how much it transforms once you actually cut those other pieces away, and now you have something totally different. So there's a strip for you.
And I like the random nature you get this way too, because you don't have any control over where those are going if you just set it up like that. So now what we would do is we would take these strips and we would use a little gel medium to just tap the ends together.
I was gonna say, and I know that these perforations, which are hard to see, you can see though how easily
they fold.
It's gonna fold right into those book pages that you need.
And that's gonna make it really nice when we go to put the book together into page form. Because what we wanna do is thicken the pages up a little. So once they're accordioned, we'll have a way to do that. So you're now taking all three strips and you're making it into one really long strip.
I was gonna say, you're just gluing them together, making it into a giant strip. So you don't have to have paper that size.
Exactly.
You can really use whatever paper you have and make it into a super big book.
And then I will set this one aside to dry for a minute, but once your pages are put together, you can just start.
Bend right along that perforation, or if you don't have a perforation, then go ahead and use a bone folder
and score it,
or anything like that.
And you can eyeball it and fold it, but you don't get as clean of an edge, so it's better to do it this way. So then when I'm done, I end up with one long piece here and a short piece, typically. You may end up with one long piece on an end, depending on what paper you use. But what I would do first, before I worry about those, is I'd come into these accordion pieces and I would adhere them together using gel medium again.
So you're just gonna put a little gel medium in there to use it as a glue to seal that up. And of course, gel medium is a transparent glue when it's dry, so you're never gonna see it even if you're a little bit messy.
Right. And what we're doing here is we're just giving these pages a little more sturdiness
And of course, you're gluing white to white. You're not putting any glue on
the
pre-colored
on the color
side.
You could
it's
if you
all
wanted
on the
to.
White.
And again, you would keep going and glue all of those together until you had them nice and adhered. And I have some here already glued.
And by the way, I like your fancy drying tool.
That's what I was gonna pull from this. A paper clip holds your accordion pieces together nicely and it keeps these out of the way while they dry.
Cool.
So now all these pages are adhered together and you would take a piece of the long end and you would use some scissors to just trim it. And you can eyeball it first. I just cut a long piece off to see. It depends on how much of that wrap piece you want to show. Marks. I kind of liked all those little dots, so I didn't want to trim all that off. So I'm going to leave it, and I will take this.
For a second, I thought you were gluing your book shut.
No.
But now I realize, of course, because it's an accordion, you have to glue one side shut or it's not a book.
To create your pages, correct. So then you have your pages in here like such. Now you can go one step farther if you like, and I'll set that aside to dry. And you can add some, take scraps or whatever and cut them into little pieces and make them more like bookbinding strips on the edges.
You know what I was gonna say is you have these really pretty leftover bits, which what you could easily do is take a decorative shape, a heart, a sort of butterfly, anything like that, go ahead and cut that out. And then you'd be able to pick out, like, I want this strip exactly to be right on the edge, you know, or I want these little, you know, plus marks.
Right, so if you end up with a piece like this that doesn't have or wasn't able to capture a lot of your marks that were in the existing pages, you can use some mark making tools to get those on there. And you can use pencils, you can use markers, and again, you'll want to try to fill in some of the white areas. If you end up like me using a piece that has some white border on it, there's a way to not have that be such a distraction. You can just get some little marks.
Well, it just melds everything together. So now how do we actually turn it into a necklace?
Okay, so you take a simple hinge clip.
Or I was going to say a bulldog clip, but a mini
little,
bulldog
yeah,
clip.
Yeah, just a little mini one. And I chose to use it on the ends that were open so that my book couldn't fall open as I was wearing it.
And so these, you get to keep your secret thoughts
inside. That's right. And you can use a simple chain like a ball chain and just feed it through the edge or the circle rather on the back of that. And then you can use your jewelry tools like I have here. So now you've got it on your clip.
Mm-hmm.
You can use simple jewelry tools to add a series of bits
and
bobbles.
Cute little embellishments and bobs
correct.
To make it even more special.
Right.
And if we look over at the finished journals that you have, we can see that not only can you wear this, but you could change them out because that's simply held by a clip. You can give them to friends. And now I can take your art and make a book of my own.